Yes, what a great blessing and privilege your grants unto us in the midst of his hag, the Mo'ad, the feast, and the celebration as we celebrate the power of the dawn of Yeshua HaMashiach. And it should be done with singing and dancing. And also he uses the word cool, or the staggering of one's step, even to the point where many was drunken because of the beauty of the fresh wine and the seasoned wine, the Yahweh, hallelujah, that they began to drink, and they enjoyed the blessings of Almighty Yah through the revelation of Yeshua HaMashiach. And as we understand that we can do all things through Yeshua HaMashiach, he is the Koach, he is the strength of Torah, then you're going to move and dance. You must get up out of your seat. It's like Jeremiah says, it's like fire. Oh, shut up in my bones. I recall as a young lad things that I can recollect in my thoughts. I cannot remember the chronological sequence of matters. You would see the old ones that they would cry out regardless to where they were. They would make known the excellence of the Mighty One. And they would do it in any circumstance, situation. They would. We have lost the fervor of that Yisrael. We have lost the impact of them coming out of such great bondage of Shibu, powers that caused their minds to wander and to ponder, yet Yah was on their side. Hallelujah. I do want to speak. Let me change courses today. I have already sent out a decree to my Ach Micaiah that I must tread grounds that are very careful today. I cannot interpretate one verse, Yahweh, by my own interpretation. It must be revealed by the preponderant of evidence. We must understand what the preponderant of evidence is. It is that which carries the superior weight, Yisrael. It has a more dynamic weight of force. It has the power to influence the mind to believe or disbelieve. And so I have put myself in a precarious position today. I said to him, if you are not satisfied, if there is no revelation of the matter, you get up with your family and you trek back to Ohio today. And so I am in a tremendous precarious position. The weight is on this natural man, but yet I have the influence of the Ruach Kodesh. I can do all things. I'm glad that I had Yosipia to sing that one last through Yeshua. And without the revelation of Yeshua HaMashiach this day, there's nothing that is relevant or shall be proven. We find this teaching today. It is out of the gates of darkness of hell that there are many that are saying that Yah does not want us to honor, to keep, or shema, to hedge around the importance of what he speaks to us, that we are not privileged in this land to keep the mu'adim. It is coming from men that are blatantly ignorant. They cannot even show you any preponderant of evidence, and I will use the vital things that they use to show you the deception of their lies. You that have joined us, I think that on this message of Ach Simeon, I will post all of the literature, the scripture that I use. I don't have books of historical value. I do have this one book. It's the volume of 4. It is called the Interpreter Dictionary of the Scripture. It says Bible. You can find a used set of these probably for around $150, that's what they will cost. Don't waste your money if you're not going to use it to collect dust. Don't get excited about it if you're not going to utilize, and then you have to, with great discretion, understand the very nature and the very purpose of one when they began to give you somewhat of a historical fact of what things that derive out of the Hebraic culture. So you have to be careful. We are a generation, whatever we read, we take it, we think we have great knowledge. I said to my Ach Simeon the other day, I believe probably 10% of what I read. I don't care if it's about scripture and things like that. Because the revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach was not in the books or the Sefer or the writings. It was revealed unto Yisrael. And so you must do an analytical type of scrutinizing of the articles. And then out of the first two or three sentences, you can tell the purpose of what one is trying to convey. And we are a generation of people who do not analytically analyze what we're reading. We just believe every damn thing. You understand, Yisrael? We believe everything. We will question the messenger of Yah. We will read every kind of book there is. And we will believe it. Not to say that I would discredit the 750 scholars. And these are men and women that have scholarship in the Hebraic language and certain subject that they have spent years on to understand the very essence and that's not the word I'm looking for. The essence and the characteristics, it is the word that I'm looking for to understand the nuances. The nuances. That's every little small bit of piece that is relevant to the whole and the full of the matter. So I cannot discredit that because it lines up with Torah. And when it lines up with Torah, when I do a research on a certain word, and if it lines up with what is written, I have no compunction. Simply, I will not fight against it. I will not argue against that. So I wanted to understand, as I've quoted unto us many times, the definitive, the absolute, settled, defined nature of what the feast represent or what it means. The word feast or hag, or mu'at. What does it imply? What does it speak? And I can go to the Torah and show you the very same thing. I want to read this definitive. And this is the work of scholars. You find people that, and I do not disregard one educational prowess, but those that have come to Yah within a span of a few weeks, they know everything. They're reproving those that have labored and mastered certain aspects of the Torah. And then their lives are not worth a damn. They live ragged lives. Their children are corrupt. Their wives are distant from Yah. The husband has no wisdom of Almighty Yah. I want to define this word, feast. I have a task here today because our Achmikaya, he is one that has a stern look all the time when he sits back there. There is no discerning from his facial expression, whether I'm reaching home or not. This one, I must reach home. You understand? It is defined this way. This is what's the Interpreter's Dictionary of the Bible. It says this. Now, a new volume of this will cost you around $400. I was able to find this set for $99. It was a well-invested $99. Hallelujah. It says, quote, the verb from which the noun, feast, a verb is an expression of a matter. So the verb that express or which is a noun, it means, this is what feast means, to make a pilgrimage. As we are commanded to enter into Yerushalayim three times a year, Yisrael. That was for this Moed Matzvah, the Feast of Unleavened Bread, and for Shavuot or Pentecost, and also for Booth or Tabernacle or Sukkah. And it implies the verb from which the noun issued means to make pilgrimage. Pilgrimage includes a procession, this is what a pilgrimage is. It includes a procession of dancing, feasting, and sometime drunkenness. We would hear the old ones would say, I was drunk in the Ruach of Almighty Yah. So it is a time of great festivity, for the hand of Yah has been poured out indelibly upon Yisra'iyah. The abundance, the riches, the substance. He has kept us in the order of the Torah that was manifested in Yahshua HaMashiach. So when we gather during these times, it should be dancing. There should be a processional. There should be the wonders of the great abundance of Yah. Not just a little tidbit of lamb, but goat's meat and all of those things that are cleaned before the Most High. I was reading this morning that 40% of this nation has never even tasted lamb's meat. They don't even know what it tastes like, Yisra'iyah. Yet Yah grants us the privilege here that we have an abundance of lamb and goats and cattle and fish in our ponds that we can eat. I will not complain about one damn thing, for nothing will damn my mind and cause me to question Yah because of some infliction or affliction or trial that I am being pressed against. I will not do him that way. I won't do that. So the question today, does Yah hate your feast days? And the answer is emphatically, with no doubt, he hates them all. It is one thing we must understand, Yisra'iyah. We are people that read, but we don't read. Yah says, I hate your Y-O-U-R. Before I began anywhere, I want to define the word your, this adjective. And we understand, even though we have come out of school years ago, we understand that in my teaching and learning that an adjective did not stand alone. It could not stand alone like a noun or verb. It was always a modifier of a noun. Am I right on that, Smahot? You're smiling because you know I'm older than your natural father and your Ima as well. So an adjective cannot stand alone. It must modify. It must make clear. It must bring light, ambience unto what needs to be clarified. All right? So Yah said, I hate your feast days. I want to show you with a pattern or task, Nuth, why he hates your feast days. Hallelujah. I want to define the word your according to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. I want you all to write these scripture down. I want you to allow this to indelibly be implanted in your mind. I'm not here to waste time. These are children of hell. They have gone out from among Yisra'iyah, but they were never of Yisra'iyah. To discredit what Yah has instituted, I want to begin with definition of words because it's important. The word your, it indicates a possessive. It's an adjective of or belonging to you or yourself or yourselves as the processor or the processor. So when Yah says your, it is you that has, it is you that have processed it. It is you that has innated it. It is you that have created it. You are the one that creates the course of the process of the processes of this matter. Again, it says the word your is a possessive. It is an adjective of or belonging to you. Belonging to you, not to him, but to you. To you or yourself. To yourself. Or yourselves, us. It belongs to us, our own teaching, our own doctrine, as possessor or processor, processor or processors. Due to you, all the honors due to you because you are the one that has created this matter. Inherit in you, it is in you. No one else put that there but you, Yisra'iyah. Associated or connected with you. He said, I hate your Ma'adem. I'm going to bring great clarity today. Don't worry. Yeah. You're going to have an understanding that you can battle these devious demons of hell. They are liars. Yeah. And I say to you all, they are manzir. They are bastards. I will show you with the preponderance of evidence. That is somewhat of a Judaist prudent statement. that the evident must be preponderant. They must be more weightier than the defense. They must have much more influence on the minds of the jurors. They must have much more power of force to come to the conclusion that you're correct. Hallelujah. Proceeding on. It is of or relating to you or yourself or yourselves as author. You hear that? That's vital. Yah says, I hate your feast days. You are the author and yourselves the author of the authors. Doers are doers, givers are givers, or agent or agents, effective by you. It has its effects, its power, by your stipulation, what you speak, what you say. No one else's birthday carries the connotation of your birthday. No one else's anniversary has the importance of your anniversary. No one's child has the importance of your child's birthday than your child's birthday. I want to use this as an example. I want to show you and show you what he hates, what Yah hates. Hallelujah. Affected by you. Experienced by you as something. You are the one that experienced this. You are the one that created this. You are the orchestrator. You are the one that is the diviner of this matter. That you are capable of. You have the power to create, to forge, and to do. And you do it in the way that you say is right. Now, I've defined your because we don't deal with that word your and one other adjective as well. All right? Yah hates your feast days. I want to begin in one place, first of all, and read this. We're going to get into the depths of this, and I'm going to finish today. I want to proceed quite fast because I have 6 pages of scripture. You can't do this with 1 or 2 pages or 1 or 2 scripture, and then you try to tie things in together and rest the Torah. I won't do that. I want to begin. He said he hates your feast days, right? I want to ask you a question. You don't have to respond to me when I say things. I want to ask you a question. When I read this from Bereshit, I mean from the book of Shemoth, the book of Exodus, I want you to turn that quickly. This is the type of Yah's expression, what he hates, Yisrael. I will prove it beyond a shadow of a doubt because I certainly do not want Achmikayah to pack his things today and leave. There can be no doubt in his mind, that in a juror's mind, there can be no doubt at all. If there is any doubt, you must set the person free. It must be conclusive. It must be defined. There must be a definitive there. There must be an authoritative influence in your mind that it is true and leaving no doubt at all. I want to begin here in the book of Shemoth, in the book of Exodus, chapter 32. I want to begin in verse 3. We understand the scenario when Yisrael, coming out of Mizraim, one of the most vilest of their activities, is made known unto us here in Exodus 32, verse 3. And all the people broke off the golden earrings which were in their ears, and they brought them to Aharon. Do you hear that? And he received them at their hand, and he fashioned it with a graving tool after he made a molten cow. And they said, these be whose? Your God now, your gods, O Yisrael, which brought you up out of the land of Mizraim. We know that Yah brought them out, but the gods were fashioned. Things fashioned in our minds, that's yours. You have the content of that in your mind. And when Aharon, verse 5, and when Aharon saw it, he built an altar before it, and Aharon made a proclamation. This was the utterance out of the Gadol Kohan's mouth. He made a proclamation and said, tomorrow is a feast. It is a hag. I hate your feast days. He says, tomorrow is a feast to Yah. That's what it says in your writing. It says it is a hawk to Yah. And they rose up early in the morning and offered burnt offerings and brought forth shalom offering And the people sat down to eat and drink, and they rose up to shahak. They rose up to mock, to play, to dance, to eat, to sing, to toy, and to mock. Yeah. It was instituted by you. He said, this is a feast day unto Yah. It was not what Yah ordained. I'm going to make it plain as I go, all right? This is the first incident of a feast that we know it was not of Yah. And this is the tasnuth, the pattern of anything that denies the name of Yah and Yahshua. These damn pagans that call upon the damn Jesus doing Pesach a matfa, it is a damn abomination, and Yah hates it. He hates their damn lies. I will prove it. He hates their damn gatherings. It is despicable unto him. He hated this damn deplorable abomination that they did. They fashioned their gods and say, these are the gods that brought you out. And on tomorrow we will have a hak. We got to dance. It said they played, they show hak, did it not? Show hak is the dance, to play, to mock, to rise up. That's what they did, Israel. Did Yah love this activity? No, he did not. He did not garner anything from that activity. It brings about the ruins of a nation and a people. I will show you a pattern of that in the book of Amos. Amos chapter 8, verse 10. Yah says this as he's about to bring an utter destruction of the remnant, to bring them down to a desolate state of mind of a people because of their sins and their wickedness. Was this in the book of Shemoth one of the most vilest activities of the worship of Hashatan? It was. I want to show you what he hates, all right? In the book of Amos 8:10, Yah says, and I will turn your feast days. So I will turn your feast. Does it say your? Your which belongs to you, yourself, yours. I will turn your feast days into Abel, into mourning as one lost their only child. How do I know that that is stated here? Because he says, in all of your shiram, all of your songs. That's why he gives us psalms, shiram, in the book of Tehillim, to sing. If you write no songs, write them from that. Write them from the wisdom of God, not what you create in your own mind. He said, all of your damned songs, he said, they're going to be turned into lamentation. And I will bring up sackcloth upon all loins and baldness upon every head. And I will make it as a mourning as an only son. And the end thereof as a bitter or a mar day. Well, the mo'adim of Yah, the times of great celebration. He says, your feast and your celebration. You built a damn god. You have placed everything above me. You honor everything. You honor every kind of damn day there is. You honor your damn hog day, your Christmas day. You honor your birthday, your papa's day. You honor your children that are wicked and vile. Yah said, I hate your feast days. Well, that's not proving nothing. I haven't got through even a half of a page of Torah teaching. He said, I hate them. I despise it. You must always go back to the Tasnuth. And it begins there in Exodus chapter 32. That's where it all begins. Was that not considered a feast? Did not they say we will have a Moed unto Yah tomorrow? Was not the pattern the same? Did they offer the burnt offerings? Did they offer the Zabak or the Zebek unto Yah? Did they offer the offerings unto Yah? The offerings of Shalom, did they not? And they do it as well in a damn pagan liturgy of lies. We can't do it, Yisrael. It must be done right, appropriate, according to Yah's commands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yah says here in the book of Nahum, he said, I'm going to perform something among you. Hallelujah. This is what I shall do in the book of Nahum 1:13. Yah says this. You got to understand what their Moed, their feast days are based upon. Nahum chapter 1 verse 13. Yah says, for now will I break his, he is talking about Belial here. this power, this demonic, worthless, vain thing, practice and activities that they are performing. And he is also talking about the people that had oppressed them, the Assyrians here. Yah says, hallelujah. Yah says, for now will I break his Belial, the yoke from off you. I'm going to break that off of you, Yisrael Gohudam. He said, I will burst your bonds in Shunda. And Yah has given a command concerning you, that no more of your name be Zarach, be sworn or scattered as seed. He said, out of the bayat of your gods. He's talking about your gods now. You are the possessor of that. He said, your name, they will not hear the name of Yisra'iyah saying that this is the God of Yisra'iyah. This is the damn beast of Yisra'iyah. This is the Belial or the Baal of Yisra'iyah. He said, no more. Will your name be scattered out of these pagan dungeons of hell and these activities of Christmas and pagan celebrations and false identities of Yah in the name of that damn Jesus, Lord and God? He said, no more. He said, no more shall it be done. Your name. Yah says, out of your house. He continued to say, out of your house. He said, out of your house, gods will I cut off the graven images and the molten images. He said, I will make your grave. He said, for you are vile. You're filthy. Yah says, you are kala, you're cursed. He's talking to this nation. He's talking to this people. We are cursed because we are participating in things that we ought not. We should not celebrate his moed in the name of Jesus, in the name of the Lord God. We should not, Yisra'iyah. I'm telling you, you can't prove that. I will prove it. You're boasting? No, I'm not boasting. I stand here firm and strong. I know my strength in this matter. And I know the weakness of these cowardly men, these boys that play. They don't know a damn thing. Hallelujah. He says in verse 15, this is key here. He said, behold, upon the hair of the mountain, the feet of him. He's talking about Yahshua now. The high priest, the feet of him that brings tough tidings. Does not Yahshua bring tough tidings? Yeah. The excellence of Yah's truth? Yeah. His feet upon the mountain that bring tough tidings. That publish shalom. Did not they offer shalom offering with that damnable molten image of the gods? Yeah. He is the one that brings shalom. We keep them all dim in the power of Yahshua HaMashiach. He cries out, oh Yehuda. He says, keep your feast. Keep your feast, perform your vows, for the Belial shall no more pass through you. He is utterly cut off. Do you hear that, Yisra'iyah? Yah said, you go ahead and keep your feast, because there will be no strength from you crying out to Belial. There will be no strength in your damn Jesus cry, your Lord cry, your Lord God cry, none whatsoever. There is only one name whereby his moedim can be kept. He hate their feast days. He said, I hate your feast days. He has given us the appointed time. There are those who say, well, you began when the moon is dark. That's a damnable, dumb, stupid assessment of the matter. He did not complicate it whereby you need a scientific, mathematical mind to equate it. The ways of Yah, not your ways. There are those that want to say, well, look at this, count that. Yes, it is. A day with Yah is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is as one day. You don't measure Yah at what you perceive to be a measure of time, man. This is a damn dumb generation. They don't love a man like me. The voice of Shirach, a profound orator of truth. Hear this, Yisra'iyah, he speaks. Shirach 43:7, he tells us when the feast, when you know the beginning of the feast time. You have to read the whole chapter of 43 Shirach. It's a beautiful chapter to read, all right? But look at what he says. He says, from the moon comes the sign for the Moedim or the feast days. Then listen now. He says, a light that wanes, just a little slither. Does it say that in the book of Shirach? Sure says that. He says, a light that wanes when it reaches the full moon. You will know it's the full moon because there's a light that wanes, Yisra'iyah. We got stupid boys today. They're not even of the manly quality. He said, when that light wanes, there's a profound teaching on that I did, how to determine the feast days of Yah. I bring out a chart and all you showing you the waning of the moon. He said, when the light wanes, when it reaches the full, you don't know it's full until you see the waning of the moon. You cowards, you don't know when it's full until you see the waning. I go into a preponderance of evidence. What David saw, what he spoke of, when he was in the field running from Shaul. It is in the book. These men don't study the Torah of Yah. They have no comprehension of what is being spoken. That's when we know when we began the Mo'adim of Yah. You understand, Yisrael, when you see it reaches fullness and you see that little slither of light, when the light wanes, you began to count. I don't give a damn what you say. I don't care what you say. Well, it says here in the book of Yeshua, it says you got to make it. No, Yah gave us, he gave us an order. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yah has ordered the constructs of the heavens. And he has taken that to confound the minds of men. His day is a day, Yisrael. He has set the moons in the heavens to give us knowledge or the sign of his Mo'adim. And all of the celestial bodies, Yisrael. Hallelujah. In the same chapter, Shadrach says here, in verse 10, Yahweh gave beauty. This is what Yah has done. Yah has given beauty to the feast. And he arranged the time throughout the year. Does it say he arranged? It says he's arranged, doesn't it? When you make an arrangement of flowers, you can take this blue, this red one, and have it right here. Then all of a sudden you arrange it again. You take the red one, put it in the back. You take the blue one, and put it on the side. So that's what an arrangement is. When one arranges, they change it. You come and say, oh, I thought the red one was there, but okay, it's still pretty. You come back and get us. There's a green one there. He is the one that arranged. And man is trying to figure that out in this mind of stupidity, a corrupt mind. You can't figure it out. It says that Yah gave beauty to the feast, and he arranged their times throughout the year while they praise Yah. This is what the Mo'adim does. It praises the Kadosh or the Kodash name of Yah. It praises Yah's Kodash name. Your feast days do not praise the name of Yah. They praise the name of the Lord God Jesus. Every Karadam Belial. But the feast days of the Mo'adim are to praise the name of Yah. And if there's no substantiation, what Shirach said by the other prophets that you're familiar to, this doesn't mean a damn thing, Yisrael. I must prove what he said. This must be proven in the book. He arranged the Mo'adim. It is a time to Barak to praise Yah's name. And the sanctuary resounding from the early morning. He said from the early morning there shall be a resounding sound that goes out of the bed of Yah. That is what his Mo'adim are for. To praise him. To give light to his name. Not to the name of Jesus. Not to the name of Lord. Not to the damn gods. That's what they did coming out of Mizraim. They built gods to say these are the gods that brought you. Damn their damn gods. Damn every damn dirty vile dog of a god. Damn your Jesus and your lords. Damn them all. I don't backpedal on that. That's what the Mo'adim are for. To praise, to exalt, to esteem his name. To lift up the name of Yah. To esteem the power of his beautiful name. Hallelujah. The writer, the very one that wrote the very and strived the order of the lips of Jeremiah, Baruch, says Baruch, first Baruch. It says this in 1:14. Baruch 1:14, first Baruch. And you shall read this Sefer, this book, the writing, which we have sent unto you. We shall read the Torah that Yah has sent unto us. He said, and to make confession in the house of Yah upon the feasts and the solemn days. Now we're talking about Yah's days now. We're not talking about your days. We're talking about Yah's days. This is what should be done. And on the close of Masvah, we're going to have the house of Yah open. We're going to make, we're going to have testimonies of the great power of Yah. We're going to have singing. We're going to have shouting and dancing and maybe very little preaching. How about that? He said, that's what it's for, Yisra'iyah. Well, you haven't said anything, man. No, Yah has spoken. Shirak says here again, I want to read this too. Refortify this in our thoughts and in our minds. Shirak says in 47:10, and he gave beauty to the feast and arranged their time throughout the year while they praise Yah's Kodesh name. Well, man that has no revelation by the mouth of the Nobi or the Nabi'im that I'm aware of, well, let me direct your attention to one that you're aware of, Melechiah, the book of Melechiah, chapter 2. Hallelujah. Melechiah chapter 2 and verse 1. This is what Yah says in the neglect of the Kohan, the Kohen, that they had neglected the vows and the instructions of Yah. Melechiah chapter 2, verse 1. He says, and now, O you Kohen, this commandment is for you. He said, if you will not hear me, you will not shema, hear to obey. Melechiah 2 and 2. If you will not hear, and if you will not lay it to your lap to give kabod, to give honor, to give reverence to my name, to Yah's name. You can't give reverence to the name of Jesus. You can't give reverence to the name of Lord and God. He said, but you must give honor to my name, says Yah of Sabaoth. I will even send a kala, a curse upon you. I will curse your blessing. Yes, I've cursed them already because you do not lay it to heart. You cannot destroy Yah. Celebrate the power of Yah's Mordem without his name being incorporated. You can do it all day long in the name of your damn Jesus. That's why the damn Jesus is different throughout the world. You're wrong, Yisra'iyah. But that's not saying what Shirak says. He says the time to give honor and to praise his Kodesh name. Yah says you have not given honor to my name. You have not taught the people that these great gatherings are to give honor to my name. If we go back to the Tasnith of Exodus, they gave name to their gods, didn't they? They did not give honor to the one that brought them out of the bondage, did they not? And that's what the Mordem are for, that we have a release and a relief from the great pressures and the battles of that time that we can gather in Yerushalayim and the laugh and rejoice of the great abundance of Yah. We must always look at the tasnut, the pattern, the construct of events. And you can't do that by looking in Revelation to understand what is written in Revelation. Or you got to go to Bereshit or Genesis to understand that. That's why we need men to be able to labor in the Torah of Yah. You're not going to get it. This is at these damn twisted thumping whorehouses where they twist the Torah of Yah. Hallelujah. You cannot, that is playing there, isn't it? True. Isn't that right? It is right. You will not give honor unto my name. Yah says you're cursed already. When these individuals do not honor his name, when they hear the name of Yah and they despise it, they are cursed, they are khala, they are arra. I don't give a damn. You can pray all day long. It's not going to mean a thing. Yah said to Yahushua and the others, get up off your knees. Find the damn dog and kill him. Oh, I know that sounds ruthless, but that's what Yah said. It's not what I said. Hallelujah. Verse 3. Yah says, behold, I will corrupt your zirah and spread dung upon your face now. Your face. Even the dung of what? Your feast. Does it say that? He said, I'm going to spread the dung of your feast. Were they giving Yah honor during these times? No, they were not. He said, that's your damn feast. That you dirty bastard. I raised you up, gave you a heritage. You damn dirty bastards, this how you think of me? Yeah. It doesn't take a scholar to tie this in together. He said, I'm going to spread some bush in your face, some dung. And I'm going to spread the dung, the filth of your damn dirty feast. Your gatherings in your face. Their feasts are dirty. They stink. They're full of harlotry and whoredom and wickedness. Or they may say they're celebrating Pesach, but they are not. They may say they are keeping atonement, but they are not, Yisra'iyah. I saw this damn filth of this vile thing they call Easter, that damn Good Friday is wicked. You don't even participate that in one bit. You don't even give any credence or any blessings to that. I don't give a damn if grandmama got a spread big enough for a king. You don't enter into a damn house of whoredom like that. You don't eat that which is sacrificed unto hell. You're sitting with spread the bush of your, spread the dung upon your face. And he said, even the dung of your feast, and one shall take you away with it. You call yourself reverencing Yah without keeping his name in the feast, you are a damn liar. And you reverence some little effeminate faggot thing they call Jesus. This fag, you can say he's black. You can say he's Mexican. You can say he's Korean. He is still a damn faggot image that was created by a damn corrupt mind. And the strength of that image from this Roman whore, which established through her pillaging and death a nation that is corrupt that we call America. The United Shotan Basin of every abomination. That's what it is, Yisrael. You cannot shema the feast without honoring his name. His name and the power of that name is revealed through the dumb of Yahshua HaMashiach. That's why we can sing in the name of Yahshua in the songs to speak of the volume and the power of Yah. And that's the truth. They didn't come through no damn Jesus. It didn't come through a damn Baal or a damn Lord. It came through Yahshua HaMashiach. And that's how it came. That doesn't speak anything to me. Well, I have established somewhat of a tazenuth of what Yah says the feast, your feast day is. That we're going to offer in the book of Shemoth, in the book of Exodus, when they built their damn gods, and they said we're going to have a feast unto Yah. Does it use the same word in your book? Feast. And when you search that out from its etymology, it is the same hag and moad. They're different expression of feast days. Like the ones what Eob's sons and daughters, that's a different expression. Other thing is Shibel, and that is one I believe is called Mikul. Different celebrations of eating and just fellowshipping. That's a feast. Hallelujah. But when Yah uses the word Hag, he's talking about a celebration unto the power of his name. You don't celebrate the damn name of Jesus and say the Lord Jesus was offered for us. It is Almighty Yah's precious promise, Yahshua HaMashiach. Turn quickly to the book of Amos 5. Now I want to show you why he said he hated our feast days, or hated the feast days of Yisrael. Amos 5:21. And you must understand why this great anger of Yah had come about. Can I read to show us Yisrael? These individuals make a statement on matters. They have no thorough knowledge on it. Let me read. It'll bring great clarity, all right? It says in Amos 5:21, Yah says, I hate, it is an enemy unto me. Yah says, I saw nay. And not only did he say, I saw nay, he said, but I despise, I reject. It is a dejection. I hate no pleasure. I hate. He uses the word your, does he not? Your feast days. He says, I will not ruach, I will not smell, or this great offering that you offer unto me, I will not perceive the odor that shall come into my nostrils. He said, I will not smell a ruach in your solemn, in your again. Does he say your solemn assemblies? Again, he used the word your. He said, I will not smell the fragrance of your solemn assemblies. I will not be a part of your gatherings. He said, I hate them all. Why you hate them, Yah? Well, there is clarity if one reads. This is a generation, but it says that here, no. Go up, you in chapter 5. Go up to chapter 3, and you will see how this was induced or introduced to HaMashiach. And then he answered through a plethora of proverbs and things to say. And they find one little verse, and they think they got something. Okay, let it be that he hates Pesach. I don't believe that. I will show you. Forgive me, Yah. It's not that I don't believe it. I know he doesn't, my bad. I will show you, all right? I'm a simple man, but I love this book. And I know how to research it as well as any man. As well as any man. I don't boast in that. I know how to. Hallelujah. If it's one thing he has put in me, he has put that ability. I may not be a singer, a prophet, can prophesy, speaking in languages, but that, he put that in me from the birth of my inmost womb. As the old one would say, make it plain then, man. Okay, let me move on. Verse 2, 22. Why is it that he hate our feast days? And let's examine the reason right here, all right? Can we do that? He tells us, he says, though you offer me burnt offerings and your meat offering, he said, I will not accept them favorably. Neither will I regard your shalom offering, your fat beast. I read in Shemoth that they said, tomorrow we will make a feast to Yah. Did they not offer up peace offerings? Did they offer up shalom offering? Again, it says, and they rose early in the morning, and they offered burnt offerings. They brought shalom offering, and the people sat down and drank, and they rose to pray. Did not they offer that? Yes. Was it a feast? Yes. But it was not the Asmodim, because they esteemed the damn gods, did they not? Yes. Yah said, I hate them. I hate them. He said, your offering doesn't mean a damn thing to me. He said, take away. He said, I don't want to hear it. He said, take away from me the noise of your shiram, your songs. Take away your damn rap. Take away your Jesus thumping. It's a damn filth to me. He said, it's a noise to my ears. That's what he says. Take away the noise of your shiram. For I will not hear the melody of your vials, or of your musical instrument. He heard that this morning. He heard Achiosibia. You can see it in his fingers and his expression in his voice. And Ozakin over there plucking on that thing. He sensed that. He received that, Yisrael. He said, I won't receive your damn song. I won't receive your Jesus song. You can sit there all damn day tomorrow singing your damn Jesus thumping songs. It doesn't mean a damn thing. He said, I don't receive your damn thumping of Jesus. He says here in verse 24, he said, but let judgment, mishpatim, run down as water and tzedek as a mighty stream. Well, how does the tzedek and the judgment come about? By us hearing the Torah, obeying what Yah commands us. He said, let it come that way, Yisrael. Let it fall like a stream unto me. He said, have you offered me, in verse 25, have you offered to me zebach or an offerings in the wilderness 40 years, O Beit Yisrael? Have you offered those offerings for 40 years and you've gone so far away from me? Look what they had done. That's why he hates their feast days. Look what they have done. I want you to hear this now. He says, but you have bronze. You have nasa. You have lifted up. You have esteemed the damn name of Jesus and Lords and God. You have bared up. But you have bronze. You have nasa. You have lifted up. You have esteemed greatly. Amos 5:26. You have bronze the tabernacle of Molech. He's talking about the God. We know who Molech was. He said, you have esteemed the tabernacle of Molech. The damn beast of a God you call that you offer my babies up in the valley of Hinnom and offer them to the fire of hell. I said to Micaiah, I wanted a little information the other day, and I looked at to see the facts or the statistical data on abortions. I said, Micaiah, how many articles you think I found? He said, I don't know. I said, give me an answer, man. You know how I am. He said, 100,000. I said, give me another answer. He said, 2 million. I said, give me another answer. He said, 10 million. I said, give me another answer. He said, 20 million. I said, give me another answer. He said, 30 million. I said, 26 million. I'm 200,000. I say, is that not confusing as hell? Does that not boggle the mind? This would not be confusing. You got 26 million. And I said, as I read articles, the statistic different from one than the other. One promoting their agenda, the other promoting their agenda. And I was talking to Oxymion. I said, don't you know they said there are 40 million abortions out of hell every year? And Simeon said, I can't believe that. I said, not so, Oxymion. I said, let me show you an example. I said, this the lying spirit of this nation. I said, can I show you something? There are 1.6 million people in China. Now, they will not even reveal the statistical data of the women that are getting abortion because of the one child policy. I said, Indonesia, there's 1 billion people. It's a Muslim stronghold, and they will kill every damn woman that does that. She does it. She got to do it on the cover. I say, you places like Pakistan, nearly a billion people. It's a Muslim enclave. You're not committed. You're not going to have abortions there. You're talking about Iran and Iraq. You cannot get by there. I said, what countries? Britain and America, Spain. You got Rome, where about the people are tied to the Roman whore. Down in South America, hell, they don't have abortions like that. They're tied to this Roman whore, this Roman dog, the damn Jesus. I said, they're damn liars. They do that to promote it's safe, it's all right. It's 40 million, so what's wrong with you? It's about money. They purport lies. And I'm reading statistics that different from here as far as day and night. I say, how in the hell do you understand what they're trying to say? They know we are gullible as hell and stupid. When men write books, it's to make money. You buy a book, you got to scrutinize the very knowledge of that man. The woman as well. We're so damn gullible and stupid. That's us as a nation of people. I'm a part of us. And so when a true man of strength speaks to us, we get mad at him. I'm going to press on my ark. Hallelujah. Y'all says here in Amos 5:26, you have lifted up, you have not saw the tabernacle of Molech, this damn heathen god that you burn your babies. That's what they do in this country and the countries abroad. There are countries that very little abortions. I said, you look at the country of the continent of Africa, there are not that many abortions. You got those in the inner cities that have become so Americanized or Britain Europeanized that they will do that. But the vast of those women have those babies there. Hell, in the boonies, they ain't having no abortion. They may have one by the natural course, but going to some doctor, going to the witch doctor, hell, it is in their culture, it is to bring forth life in the barefoot children. It's in this damn dirty nation. It's in Britain. It's in France where these dirty beasts, this harlotry of spirit. There are no 40 million abortions a year. It's not. Believe me, it's not. It's not, my Beth. Because you only got a few countries that put them away like they have the technology and the skill. Portugal, places like Spain, and places like a country like South Africa, one of the major countries in that continent. And places like Libya, hell, they didn't have abortions there. Places like Egypt, what they call the sub-Saharan or the northern part of Africa. Those countries are Muslim countries. And if the women are doing that, they're doing it backyard. And there's no statistics on that. So they want to bring everyone into this same ball of wax, just like the damn dirty feast days that they're having. Yes. Hallelujah. Yeah. And that is the truth. You don't have to buy, but it's still the truth. Amos 5 and 26. But you have bronze the tabernacle of Molech. You killed your babies. He said, and not only Molech, but you have lifted up this damn god called Kion. This one that has caused you to do all kind of apostasy that represent the planet of Saturn. You have Kion. You have lifted up this god because you look into the heavens and you lift up these beings and these powers that you think give you strength. He said, your image. Listen now, he says, what your images? He hates your feast days. He says, your images, your damn image of Jesus, your damn image of the Lord God. He said, your images, he says, the star of your God. The star of your God, which you made to yourself. You have made your feast days to yourself. You have made your Jesus feast day. You have made your Lord feast day. You have made your black feast day. You have made your white feast day. You have made your damn Jew feast day. I'm not taking anything back. I'm sick of what I hear in these weak men that think that they're strong men. I'm sick of their weakness. These little damn boys. Yah says, therefore, will I cause you to go into captivity beyond Damascus, Dimashech, says Yah, whose name is Yah of Sabaoth. Did he tell us his name? He said, you got your gods. I hate your feast days. Why? Because of the apostate and the abomination that you've incorporated. You have come out of Mizraim. You built a damn god because you looked into the heavens, you saw a bright star. You built a god after the order of that fashion. And that has been in your DNA ever since. Yah said, I hate them. He said, although I know you're ignorant and I want to accept you, you're my people, I will deal with this factual. He said, I hate your damn feast days. I despise them because you forgot my name. You've forgotten the praises of my name. You go to these places, they're dead. Their congregations don't even believe you should sing. There are places that believe that singing is wrong or dancing, but yet the book tells us to do that, Israel. Yeah. And they say that was of Christianity. You're a damn liar. It is of the Torah. It is what Dawid did. It is what the messengers did. When they came out of Misri, Miriam said, give me a timbre or tambourine. And she began to dance and to sing. And she is known as, she's known to Nabah, to prophesy and to speak. And the battle of Tizayon follow. And they dance and they sing to the name of Yah. Great is his name. Mighty is the name of Yah. They sang even in the same type of forcefulness and power as the song of Moshe. They dance with the timbrels. They sing. They lifted up his name. Hallelujah. He gave them ordinance and construct of keeping the feast days. If you are, he gave us as the moon rise to its beauty and the waning of the moon. We know it has reached full. That's when you know it's a full moon. That we speaks on the same matter. We just don't understand words. We think we understand a word in our own dialect. We think we understand it. We don't understand. If I ask you what your mean, well, you know it means your. You know what I mean. No, I don't know what you mean. We define it by our limited experience, Yisrael. Well, you know your mean. You're giving me an example of what your is. I mean, if that's your house, but that's not defining your. Hallelujah. I got to press here because I don't want this man to leave. You understand? I can't fail today. I fail many times, but this day I'm not going to fail. You hear me, Ma'ak? I will not. Well, that's only one indication of that. Well, let me direct your attention here in the book of Yeshaya, Isaiah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the book of Yeshaya, Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 1. I want to begin reading at verse 1. It's vitally important I read this. There's a few verses here. Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 1. It says here, the vision or the chazon, the revelation of Yah, of Yeshaya, the son of Amoz, which he saw concerning Yehuda and Yerushalayim in the days of Uzziah, Yotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, king of Yehuda. Listen to this now, verse 2. He says, Shemach, O Hashemayim, O heavens, and give ear, give ozen, hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for Yah has spoken, I have nourished, has he nourished us? I have nourished and brought up children, and he says, they rebel or they poshach against me. They poshach, they rebel, they transgress, they're hard-headed. Did he not say he raised up children? Come on, you parents that have raised up children, there's nothing more debilitating to the heart than to see your children rebel and speak with abandonment to you. There's nothing like that, is it? I have never experienced that. You are parents that have experienced. There's nothing more crushing and crucial to one's heart when you see your sons and daughters walk away from principles that you know are right. You've taught them, tried to instill in their bosom, and then they began to go their way. There's nothing more debilitating than that. That's an agony to any Ima heart. I don't care what the situation is. I don't care how she soothed. There's always that little bitterness of the agony there. That's an agony to any Avat's heart. Any man that has any kind of care, any kind of concern. Understand that. We still have to press beyond that, Yisrael. Listen to what the Torah says. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, I want you to give you. He said, I brought up in verse 2, I brought up children. He said, and they have poshach against me. He said, The ox knows his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Yisrael does not, yada, they don't know me. He said, my people don't even consider me. He says a sinful nation, a people laden, kabet, abundantly, Isaiah 1:4. They are laden with sin, with iniquity. Seeds of evildoers, children that are corruptors, they have azab, they have forsaken Yah, and they have provoked the Kodesh, one of Yisrael, to anger, and they have gone backwards. Now that is the state and the mind of Yisrael. That's their condition. There's a reason that I read that, to show you why we have gone to these feast days, and we don't give honor unto Yah. We are sinful people. We are people that's full of ovon. We're an iniquitous people. We don't care what the Torah says. We reject that. We have no desire for that. And he said all that. Does he identify the nature of a people? Does he show us how we are? He shows us the nature, our seed, what we are bringing forth. He shows us that, doesn't he? Now, down in the 10th verse, I will show you, see, this is the nature of us, isn't it? Why do you think he hate our feast day? Because we're evildoers. We're liars. We're corrupt. We're going to Shema. We're going to keep the feast days of Yah. I don't give a damn if it's nothing but two of us. We're going to honor them. He goes down in the 10th verse, and I will show you why he hates the feast days. Now, we are evil people. We are corrupt. We're full of iniquity. We are a sinful nation. We don't even know Yah. That's why they don't want to keep it. They don't know Yah. They just got a lot of damn talk. Well, I don't see why. I know you don't see because you have no spiritual enlightenment. Now, let's read here in verse 10 down to verse 15. Can I do that, Ma'ach Yosipiyah? Can I do that, Zachin Shemri? All right, then. Hallelujah. He says, hear the word of Yah, you rulers of Sodom. Give ear unto the Torah of our sovereign. Does he say give ear to the Torah? Is not the Moedim written in the Torah? Has that been rejected by Yah? No, it hasn't. I will show you. He said, give ear to our sovereign master, you people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your offerings, your zebach, your sacrifice? He said, what purpose is to that? You offer much, Isaiah 1:11. You offer much. He said, what purpose is that to me? You offer all this. He said, I'm sick. I'm damn sick. I'm full of your burnt offerings, of rams, and fat of fed beasts. I delight not in the blood of the bullocks or the lambs or in the goats. That's why he didn't delight in, because they were wicked. They were sinful. They were corrupt. He hated it. He despised it. That's why a man cannot make pala unto Yah. He know he has not gotten it right with his neighbor. A bath cannot get right, and she knows she's full of damn hypocrisy. He doesn't hear that. He says, I'm sick of you wicked people. That's what he is saying. That's what he's saying. He said, your damn offerings mean nothing to me. I've gotten so many of you killing the fattest of the beast, and you kill it, and then you lay down and mock, you play the next second. He said, I'm sick of that. That's what it's all about. He said, I'm sick of your wicked ways. He said, bring no more shav, empty, falsehood, vain testimony, and oblations. He says, your kittor, or your incense of the smell of the offerings of the fragrance that should be sweet unto me. He says, no more your vain oblation, your incense. He says, it is a to'eba, it is a filthy, vile, the smell stinks in my nostrils. He said, the months, look what he identified, the months and the Shabbat, the calling of the assembly, I cannot put up with it. He said, I cannot put up even with your Shabbat. Is that not today Shabbat as well? Is that not a plural Shabbat? That's what he says. He said, I'm sick. He, not only did he call, name the months, the begatting of the month, the acknowledging of the month, the celebration, the Moedim, he said, your months and your Shabbats and the calling of the assembly. So does he hate the Shabbat? But he hates the feast days. What feast days? His feast days? I will bring some clarity to that, my Zakin. He said, I cannot put up with it. It is iniquity. It's full of lies. You gather on your damn Sunday, you gather on the Shabbat and call on Jesus. You call on the Lord, that's a damn abomination. He said, you're full of iniquity. He said, even the solemn feast, even the solemn, that which is set apart, your gathering, your assembling together. He said, even them. He said, your month, listen, what he says here, does he say my month or your month? He says, your month. Your Kodesh, your month. He says, and your appointed feast, your feast that you appoint. Your. Can I read what the word your mean again? I will read that after this. He said, your appointed feast. He said, my nephesh, my being hates. He said, they are a trouble to me. He said, I am weary. I am impatient. I'm exhausted with you damn beasts to bear them to Nasat, to even accept, to even let you advance in them. I'm not even a part of it. What did Yah say? He says, your feast days, your solemn assemblies, your gathering. Was that not a solemn assembly after they came out of Mishraim? Was that not a feast, Yisrael? Did they offer up offerings to Yah? Did they offer up sacrifices? Right after that, before that, Miriam had picked up the timbrel and sing to his name. Hallelujah. And then sometime later, they're offering up to a damn freak of a god. Every god is a damn freak. A freak of a god. a freak thing. It is something that your mind has made, your thoughts has created. And you're just pursuing the thoughts and the creativity of others, Yisrael. Yah says, when you spread forth your hands, I will hide my eyes from you. Yes, when you make many prayers, I will not hear. Listen, he said, your hands are full of dam, full of blood. Do you see the condition why he hated their feast days? They were wicked. They were vile. Men that don't eat, you know, these wicked men, they're not going to keep the more dim of Yah because they're wicked. They're cowardly little jackasses. They're little boys. They're little boys. They can't even quote you five writings of the Torah. You see, no deliberate effort. When I was a young man, I would take my book to work. I didn't play around. I didn't grab ass. I didn't jaw jack. When it was lunch, I would take my book and study. I would go out to my vehicle and study. No, I didn't parade it before everyone. Every time I had a moment, I would take time because I knew when I got home that was grass and that was this to do, that was that to do. And in the wee hours of the night before I went to bed, I would take time to study, not read, but to take time to study, to open my concordance and study what the book said. So that's why he hated them or them. Did he hate that what they did in the Tasnu? Do we see the beginning of feast days? Do we not see the beginning? This is a more a dem unto Yah. Was it one that Yah had ordained? He did not ordain the name of Jesus Christ among us. He did not ordain the name of Lord among us, Yisrael. That's why he hates it. Your baby's coming in there with every kind of a fornicating, adulterous spirit, pregnant, offering up their babies to the fire of this damn world. No discipline in your homes. Little gals in there rolling with their bellies open 14, 15. And you think you're celebrating Yah. You're not celebrating Yah. You have not given them the honor and the teaching of the Torah to warn them against their dirty whoredom and their prostitution. You go to these damn dirty whorehouses, they're going to go tomorrow, this vile filthiness. And these damn folks that love their Jesus, they're going. These whole houses that say they don't celebrate Easter, but they celebrate it. The folks will put on their new wares. Something new and something old. Where did that damn mess come from? I guarantee his wife, Miss Jezebel, will be in there with a fine suit on. I guarantee all of his children will be dressed up. And that's the truth. And they go to these damn dirty whole houses and get a nice, feel nice. Or they will preach about the death of Yahshua, and yet they deny the Pesach. The beginning of Yah's Moed because of their damn dirty Jesus and their damn dirty ways. I'm not bending on that. I don't care who it offends. Go find you some Jesus thumper, some Lord thumper, some God perverted God thumper. Don't come to me with that. Don't write me about it either. Hallelujah. 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 That's why he said, I'm not going to hear your prayers because your Moedim, your feast days are dirty. Moving on quickly. Let us go back here now. We were talking about your. I want to read this again, the word your. Hallelujah. The word is a possessive. It is an adjective. An adjective is a modifier of a noun, Yisrael. It is of or belonging to you or yourself or yourselves as the possessor or possessors due to you, inherit in you, associated or connected with you, or relating to you or yourself or yourselves as author or authors. So did Yah author the feast days of Yisrael? Did Yah author the feast days? Sure, he's the author. How do I know? Because it says this in Shemoth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shemoth, Exodus 12:11. Yah says, and this is how you shall eat the lamb or the offering. We can't eat the body of Yahshua without having our loins girded in the disciplines of the Torah. As I saw, okay, bro, come on. It's not that little piece of bread we ate. That's not the communion of Yah. It is the fellowship in the body of Yahshua. Yahweh says, truly our fellowship is with the Abba and his son, Yahshua, HaMashiach. Exodus 12:11. And this is how you shall eat it, with your loins girt, your shoes on, your feet, on your feet, and your staff in your hand. Everyone had their own staff and their own shoes. My shoes are not your shoes. We're talking about the possession or the possessor of your shoes. And you shall eat it in haste. It is not Jesus' Pesach. It is Yah's Pesach. But he hates his Pesach. I will prove that he doesn't hate Pesach. I will prove it. All right, Yisrael. It is the Pesach of Yah. We would deal so. The word my is a possessive, isn't it not? I would define the word my. And I want to deal with some substance of my and your, okay? The word my, according to the Merriam-Webster, it means of or belonging to me or myself as possessor. Did not he say this is Yah's Pesach? He did not say it was Jesus' Pesach. He did not say it was the Lord God. This is Yah's Pesach. He is the possessor of that. Due to me, inherited in me, associated or connected with me. Is the Pesach associated and connected with Yah? It's not connected with Yisrael, it's connected with Yah. Is it not? That's what it means. See, men don't look words up. They speak from the ignorance of their child bringing, and they don't even crack a damn dictionary. That's what the word me mean. It is the same. It is an adjective as well. It is a modifier. So when he say my, we're going to see what my modifies. We're going to see what my speak to, all right? It also relating to me or myself as author. Can I read that again in Exodus 12, 11? And this is how you shall eat it, with your loins girt about, your shoes on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it in haste. It is Yah's Pesach. Is he the author of that? Is he the one that ordained Pesach? Is he the one that gave the instruction for Pesach? So he's the one that is a possessor and the processor of Pesach. Is he not? Is he not? He said it is Yah's Pesach. So it shows a possession that it belongs to me, Yisrael. Also the author, the doer, and the giver. He is the agent whereby the knowledge of Pesach comes from. No one else. He still hates our feast days. And to understand the feast days, we must go back to Exodus. When Aharon, as they offered a feast unto Yah, that's what it said. That was their feast days, and Yah still hates them. It was full of vile abomination. It was a cursed thing to do. And these feast days that curse the name of Yah and dispose his name and bring a damn Jesus, the Lord Christ. It's a wickedness, Yisrael. Yeah. It's wrong and it's vile. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. And so they use that to say, Yah hates your feast day. Yeah, he hates your feast day because you're a vile, wicked bastard. You're a damn dog, man. You will not do it right anyway. You don't even open your mouth to Yah. You don't even lift his name. You don't even esteem him. You don't even call upon his name. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. I want to show you one profound key to this matter in the book of Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to show you two profound things. Look, quickly, Exodus 12, 27. This is what Yah says when the little ones are being, that we cause this to be engrafted in their bosom. Exodus 12, 27. When our children to say to us, they ask us, why are we doing all this dancing, mom and daddy? Why is all this so beautiful in the celebration? This is what Yah says in Shemoth 12, 27. He said, that you shall say, when they ask you, what's the reason for this? You should, it is a zibach or a zabach of Yah's Pesach. Who pass over the Beit or the Behim of the children of Yisra'iyah and Mishraim when he smote the Mishraim and delivered our houses. And all the people bowed their head and they shachah, they worship Yah. When they shall ask you, what is the reason for that? You shall say, this is the Zabach of Yah's sacrifice. This is him, not our feast days. Not you sacrificing to a damn dirty dog, the god of Sarim or Molech or Molcham. Not to a damn Lord of Baal or Belial, Yah. Not to that Yisrael, Yah. Not to your flesh. Not your gathering of your comfort and your drunkenness and your dancing. But these are Yah's, Mo'adam. This is my feast, he said. He doesn't hate what belongs to him. I will prove it with resounding proof in Torah. My means possession. You are the author. It belongs to you. Well, if he hate that, then everything that my, he must hate. All right? Let me move on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Also in the book of Weyira, Leviticus, I want to show you the key to this whole matter, Yisrael. Leviticus 23:2. He says, speak, Leviticus 23 and verse 2. You all write this down and go back and study it and read it. You can just read it and come to the same conclusion that I'm going to teach us today. It says in Leviticus chapter 23, verse 2, he says, speak to to the children of Israel. Are we the children of Israel? He did not say to the heathens, he said, speak to the children of Israel. These are damn heathens out there. They call those that are white and Jewish and brown and black heathen, but they are the damn heathens. He says, speak to the children of Israel. Say to them concerning the Moedim of who? Of Yah. He hates your feast days. These are my Moedims, which you shall proclaim to be a mikra, a convocation, kodesh, even these are, does he use the word my? Yes. Is that a possessive? Yes. These are my Moedim. These are my Moedim. Again, quickly, I want to read that meaning of the word my. It is of or belonging to me or myself. Does the feast belong to Yahim himself? Is it not his? Is he not the possessor of that? Due to me, what the feast commands us is to give unto him that is due to him. It is his moed, Yisrael. He said, due to me, inherit it in me. It is my right that I can command you to do that. It's his inheritance. That's what the moedim are for, to keep a memory of him in our thoughts and celebration of his great acts of mighty power for us. Associated or connected with me, the Moedim is connected with Yah. Just like his Torah, his laws, are they not connected with him? Are they not connected with him? Well, I will prove it then. You see me perspiring up here because this man, he's back there. He is judging every word. His Ishaw is taking down the scripture, and he is going to scrutinize them and say, man, you're either wrong or you're right. Hallelujah. Is connected with me or relating to me myself as author, doer, giver, or agent. Is he not the one that instructed? Is he not the one that ordained? Is he not the author of the Moedim? Sure he is. He is. He said, this is my Pesach. It doesn't belong to the damn Jesus of the Lord. It belongs to Yah. And his name must be esteemed. For without that name, you have no power of your Yashak, no salvation. You have no strength of his Yahshua. There's no power in the words that you read. He said, this is my Moedim. Not just Moed, but Moedim. They belong to me. I watch over these. And what you're offering in your feast days, damn it all, is filthy. Because you are corrupt. My is what belongs to Yah. When he said, it is my, it belongs to him. All right? Are we his people? He hates us? No, he doesn't hate us. He corrects us. And he will kill us. But he still loves Yisrael. Come on, Yisrael. Don't be afraid to answer it. Hallelujah. My, what belonged to him. I want to deal with some aspects of the Torah on just that one word. Quickly, Bereshit. Bereshit 26, verse 5. This is when Yah promised unto Abraham he was going to physically renew the power of his loins, and there shall be multiplicity among Yisrael in every nation, although he may scatter them. He says this in Genesis Bereshit 26 and 5. He says, because that Abraham obeyed whose voice? It's my voice, my call, my voice. Is not the Moedim belong to Yah? Does he hate his voice? No, he doesn't hate his voice. He hates your voice, and he hates your Moedim. He said, my voice, and he kept my charge, my shofar, my command. He kept my mitzvah. You tell me Yah hates his mitzvah? Although we break them and we defy them, he doesn't hate mine. He hates your commands. He hates our laws. He hates our ways. He said, my mitzvah, because he kept my mitzvah and my chukim and my statutes. And he said, my Torah. Does he hate my Torah? That's why he's precise. He said, I hate your feast days. Do you hear me? He did not say, I hate my feast days. There's nowhere in the book they're going to find that. He said, I hate your feast days. I hate your feast days. I hate your feast days. You have corrupted your feast days. And you're trying to offer that as my feast days. He said, damn it all. He said, I hate your feast days. I hate your ways. I hate the way you do things. Are you trying to put it off? That's mine. It's not my Moedim. Because in my Moedim, you lift me up, you dance, and you stag. The old fellow says, oh, man. Just like my Zakein said, I know this is Yah's work in me. Because there are things that I would not do only Yah. Come on. You tell me that's not esteeming Yah, lifting him up? Hear me, this man praising Yah louder than you that say you love Yah? Come on, Yisrael. That is the truth. Hallelujah. And these cowards don't even lift up the name of Yah? That's not so. So did he hate his statutes? He did not hate his modem. He did not hate his laws. He said he's showing the possession if he isn't. Did he not say that this is my modem? Are they not equal with his Torah? Are they not a part? Are they not of the same light of his Torah? Yisrael, sure they are. We got fools out here. We got blind gods leading the blind and everybody falling into the ditches. They want to talk about the New World Order. Damn the New World Order. They want to talk about the Club of Rome. Damn the Club of Rome. Damn the Catholic whorehouse. Damn them all. Damn the doctrines of the Muslim. Damn the doctrines of the Jews and all of that mess. I believe what the Torah says is simple. He made it so simple that an ignorant people that's laden down with sin, that his voice will speak unto them. He said, because Abraham obeyed my voice. Does Yah hate his voice? He doesn't hate his voice, Yisrael. Yah, hallelujah. Wayera, Wayera, Leviticus 26:2. Hallelujah. I want to find, let me see if I can find this quickly here. Ah, help me, you all bear with me, please. And don't allow yourself to be overbearing, okay? Don't get, become sullen. There's something I read, I want to go back to it. Hallelujah, hallelujah, show me, y'all. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Concerning the Shabbat, anyone remember that? Let me find it quick. I'll find it. That's why I print everything out so I can go back and see it quickly. Hallelujah. I want to show you something, Yisrael. I'm a student more than anything. I study this book. I'm not boasting in that. The verse I just read that concerning the Shabbats and the months and the Shabbats, I can't recall where it was from. Hallelujah. I got it right here. I want you to go, where did I say go to? Wayera chapter 26. All right? No. Wayera 26. Leviticus 26. I want you to go back, turn quickly, hold both spaces now, and go back to Isaiah, Yeshaya 1:13. I want to prove something to us, Yisrael. We can't learn unless we're able to hear. All right? It says here in the book of Yeshaya, Yah says, because he's going to bring a severe censor or a severe separation upon us. Why? He says here in Yeshaya, Isaiah 1:13, he said, bring no more vain, a sharp, empty, falsehood, oblation, incense. It is an abomination to me. He said, the months, the Shabbats, does it say Shabbats there? He said, the months and the Shabbat, the calling of the assembly, I cannot put up with. It is an iniquity, even the solemn feast. Does Yah hate his Shabbat? Does he hate his Shabbat? Okay, now go over here to Yira, Leviticus 26:2. Now he said, your Shabbats, I hate them. Did he not say that? Did he not? He said, I can't bear them no more. Come on, Yosipi, I bear with it. Did he say that, my son? Is this analogy wrong? It's right. He said, I hate that, didn't he? Now look what it says in Leviticus, Yira 26:2. Hallelujah. 26:2. He said, you shall Shema, you shall keep my Shabbat or Shabbats. He says, Shabbats. He doesn't hate his Shabbats. He hates your Shabbats. He said, you shall keep my Shabbats. And he says, and reverence my Mikdash place. He said, for I am Yah. Does he hate his Shabbats? He doesn't hate them. But our Shabbats, he hates them because they're pagan. They're full of lies. Because his name is not lifted up. It's all about flesh. It's exalting flesh. Laughter and folly. This is no time to be mocking. No time for laughter. No time for me to be up here laughing and clowning like a jackass. Hallelujah. No time for that. He said, if you walk in my chukim, if you walk in my statutes, in the next verse, if you walk in my statutes and keep my mitzvahs, does he hate his mitzvahs? But he hate our laws. He hate our Torah. He hate our statues. I got a statue where my wife is more important than anyone else. That's a damn lie. The body's important. I'm supposed to love her more than anyone else. That's a damn lie. That's my sister. So I will cover her sin, but I will not hide your sins. That's not what he says, Yisrael. He said, keep my mitzvah. He doesn't hate his mitzvah, but he hate your mitzvah. He said to Asa, to do them, Yisrael. To do them. Does he hate his mitzvah? He doesn't hate his Shabbat, but he hate your feast days. He hate your feast days. The first feast day was kept. Did he hate that one? He did not hate Pesach. But the one when they came out, he hated that one. And that is the task, nuth, or the pattern of all feast days of man. You understand? His feast days is pattern, the construct is from his bosom. Hallelujah. He doesn't hate his mitzvah. He doesn't hate his commandments. You can't send me, show me where you say, I hate my commandments. I hate my Torah. He said, but I hate your possession, your construct of a feast day. I hate it. I hate what you do on my Pesach. I hate it. I hate the way you come together. Your damn hypocrisy. You don't even come together with unity. You don't come together to blend in with each other. You got your little group here and you got your little say here. And this little group comes and say he's wrong and that little group. That's why I tell people, don't come here and tell us a damn thing now. You don't come here and tell me a damn thing. Until you do this and get to where we are, then you come tell me. Don't come here with that with me now. You may take it to someone else, but you're not coming here with that. Had this joker put a post on our YouTube space. Ma'ak, you forgot to exalt the name of Yah. You know, people are stupid. I don't even answer jokers like that back because they're stupid. He doesn't hate his mitzvah. He doesn't hate his judgment. He doesn't hate that. He hate your judgment. Your damn judgment is crooked. How can you say that? I will show us. I'm moving on, my Zakin. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Drop quickly down to verse 9 in the same chapter. Verse 9. If we obey those things that Yah command us, my statutes, my mitzvah, my commands, keep my name and reverence my kodesh, please. That's why you don't come in here just any kind of way. You don't come in here dressed any kind of way. You don't come in here with the dress up of your barak and you've been sweating all day and you smell like a stinking pig. You cleanse yourself. That's why I put those prayer benches out there. They're facing Yerushalayim. You don't dishonor the bed of Yah Yisrael. Hallelujah. In verse 9, he said, for I will have, pana, I will show signs of turning. I will have respect to you and make you fruitful and multiply you. And look what he says, and establish my covenant with you. Does Yah hate his bread? He has a covenant with Yisrael. We sin and we do wickedly, but does he hate his covenant? He doesn't hate his covenant, but he hates the covenant we have with him because it's built upon falsehood and lies. He hates our ways. He hates what we do. And he has to cause us off to rise and he kill your babies and you as well. He hates our ways, but he doesn't hate his ways. Hallelujah. He doesn't hate his ways. Hallelujah. We are the one that hate his commands. You can't say that, man. Well, look what it says in the 15th verse of the same chapter. I'm moving through the Torah. I don't want to read all the verses. You go in that filling. But look what it says in the 15th verse. Yah says, and if you shall despise my, is he still the possessor of that? Yes. My huchem. Or if you, or if your, now he's talking about you now. Your now. My and your. You possess. Come on. We have to know how to possess our nefesh in the fear of Yah. Does not Yah commands us to save your nefesh? To save your, to save you, to save your, to save you, to save your from this untoward generation? Is that not a command of Yah? You can't save me, you save your. And if you despise my hukam or your nefesh abhor my mishpatim, so that you will not do all, again he says my commandments. You will not do all my commandments, but that you break my covenant, he says I'm going to bring death on you. So Yah hates his covenant with us, although we're wicked, he doesn't hate that. No more than he hate his feast days. He hate your feast days. He hate what we have incorporated, the name Jesus and lords and gods. The white God, the black God, the brown God, the Jew God, the Chinese God. The Jew Jesus, the Chinese Jesus, the black Jesus, the white Jesus. I don't give a damn if it costs you to have a little nervousness about that. Damn every white Jesus. Damn every black Jesus. I serve Almighty Yah through the power of Yahshua HaMashiach. These folks talking about lineage and heritage doesn't mean a damn thing. They want to talk about identity and esteem the creature more than the creator, and they live wicked as hell. Men out here calling themselves men, talking about, I'm of the true lineage of Israel, and will not even take his damn house. He's a jackass. Always esteeming the flesh and not the creator, not obeying the Torah of Yah. They're damn jackasses. Don't write me and tell me stop cursing, because the word ass is in the book, and I'm going to say it, all right? As Bishop Bank would say, it's in the book. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is it not my commandments and my covenant? Does he hate his commandments? You tell me y'all hate these mitzvahs? He hate the covenant with us, the Brit, his allegiance, his alliance. That's what a covenant is, the Brit is. It's his allegiance, his alliance. It is the betrothed, it is the marriage too. Come on. He doesn't hate that. He hate your alliances. He hate your allegiance. He hate you. He hate your ways that you align yourself with the wicked and the most vilest of individuals. You can sit down and eat and feast with them and have a zikron, a day of remembering. They say, we're going to remember mama's birthday. And hell, you run here to China to get something for mama. That's the truth. We're going to remember the grandbaby. They'll give grandbaby a stick on their buttocks. Bad as hell and rebellious and hard-headed, dishonor you and disrespect you. Granddaddy, give me 10, I'll give you a damn knuckle side your head. I say it that way. I will, man. Grandmama can't get you to take the garbage out, you lazy pig. You get the mourning and groaning because of that. You'll say, I hate your ways, I hate your feasts. He doesn't hate his feasts. He doesn't hate his mishpatim. Verse 42 of the same chapter. Yah says, now what I want you to do is repent. That's what he wants us to do now. Verse 42 of the same chapter. Yah says, if you do all that I tell you, you remember my, and don't despise my more. Damn, don't despise my ways. Yah says, then I will remember my Brit with Yaakov. Is not Yaakov Yisrael? Yes. We have prevailed by the power of Yah. We have the strength and the authority of his testimony, a living testimony of Yeshua. He said that I remember Yaakov. I remember what I brought him through and how I delivered him. I remember Yaakov, also my Brit, my covenant. Does Yah hate his covenant? No, sir. He hate our covenant relationship with each other. But he doesn't hate his Brit because it's genuine and true. He said, I remember my Brit, my covenant with Yitzhak, and also my covenant with Abraham. And I will remember, the land, the place where I promised to Yisrael. Leviticus 26:43. He said, the land also shall be left of them and shall enjoy her Shabbats. Now, Yah doesn't hate his Shabbat, but he hate our Shabbats. He hate our Shabbat. You got these damn fools today say, well, the Shabbat began, it begins on the morning. So it's not the Shabbat. It doesn't begin in the evening. You got all kinds of doctrines out there, Yisrael. They're not doctrine. They're just lying deceptions of hell. And everywhere Yah tells us at the evening, the beginning, the Yalach, and the Bukah was the first day. And these pigs, and folks buy that. And they try to argue that. And they will try to dispute you. I don't even have time for fools like that. You come to me, it's because you need some reproving and some correction. Hallelujah. Yah says, and he says, and you shall enjoy her Shabbats. And yet I just read that Yah said he hate your Shabbats. And your Shabbats are filth and they are vile. He said they shall enjoy the Shabbat while she live desolate without them. We have been living desolate without the beauty of the Shabbat of Yah. While they lie desolate with him. And they shall accept, of the punishment for their iniquity. We must pay for our iniquity. We must say, correct us, Yah. We're worried about Yah correcting the wicked that have oppressed us and did us wrong. Correct me, Yah. Correct me in thy judgment and not in thy off, lest you bring me to nothing. In your judgment, not my judgment, your judgment, Yah. Yah says here, because they despise my mishpatim. Does it say that? He doesn't despise his mishpatim. He said, great blessings upon you if you keep my judgment. He said, but we despise his judgment, and because the nephesh hated, abhorred my statutes, my hukam. We hate the statutes of Yah. That's why we have liars and these perverters, men that have stood in this rostrum, and now they say you don't keep the moedim of Yah. men that have stood here, they are liars. They're corrupt men. They're vile men. Yah doesn't hate his judgment. He has done away with his statutes. We do all things through the power of Yahshua. You have the ability to read the 613 laws. You will comprehend them no way. But they're in the body of Yahshua. You don't have to practice them. It's an innate willingness in you that you obey them. You may not understand what you do, but when you hear the power of that revelation, it quickly transforms your mind and sets you in line with Yah. Yeah. Come on, Yisrael. Yeah. You have no ability to do it. You reverence the Shema because you don't want to do anything that offends Yah. You're not trying to cook and go here and run there and do that and all of that. You rest like he says. That's how you do it. You don't have to go and see if you broke the law by lighting the fire and all that because you know what you're doing, Yisrael. It's in your bosom. He has written. He has hatab that in your mind. You tell me hate that. Yeah. Yahshua did not come to destroy the Torah. And his writings of his modem is in the Torah. Well, we are not in the land. Well, with the Syrophoenician woman, said the Yahshua, that there's only one place you can worship Yah. And that is in Yerushalayim. And that is the truth because Yeshaya says that. So we're not worshiping Yah, then we're not Shaha. These are ignorant men. They're ignorant men. And I've contacted them, but they won't contact me. They will not contact me. You think they're going to have me in their gathering? I'm not offended at that. I don't want to go anyway. I like being here working. My mind is bent on putting up fence tomorrow. Believe me. I woke up this morning thinking about fencing. How am I going to do it? How am I going to do this the quickest way, the best way? Come on. Hallelujah. I got work to do. Don't come here thinking we're going to sit down and chit-chat. And you're trying to show me what you know and what you have. You possess nothing. Because a wise man, his gift would make room. His labor, his walk will speak in great volumes. Say, who is that man? And a foolish man speaks his mind. But a wise man, he's quiet. He says, you don't know a thing, boy. Moving on, I got work to do here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We cannot despise. He said, you despise my mishpatia, my judgment, because the nephesh hate my statutes. That's what we hate. That is a statue. He gave us a statue concerning the modem throughout all whole generation. Again, did he not say that? Throughout all our generation. When our children ask, why do we do this? Because it is the Pesach of Yah. It is Yah's Moed. That's why. So we do it in a celebratory way. We fix up and we fix up the place for our children. I saw that little fella back there. He was just rolling. No, I'm talking about you. He was just rolling. Yeah, you were. He didn't know why he was rolling like that. That's right. He's supposed to do that. He was kicking on them legs. That's how he was doing back there. As old folks say, don't mess with that child, it'll get at him. Even when they're mocking, that's all right. The children, they do things. When you were a child, you did foolish things, didn't you? All right, stop it. Don't mess with them. Let them do it. They come in here, in short, say, y'all say, no, let them run. I want them to run. Don't stop them from running. Let them run. You're not going to run. Let them run. Slow down. No. I don't want any control. Let them run. I don't want to control. I don't want them to walk. I'm going to run. Hallelujah. Don't control it. Hallelujah. Can I move on, little father? I hope he doesn't have his sword drawn back there. Bathe in that thing. He may be pulling it out his sheath. I got to get the roll here. Actually, it's not going to be mean. I got to move because I certainly don't want him to. Hallelujah. Can I move a little farther here? I would ask us a question. You don't have to answer. Now, I want to show you some of the possession or the possessors of Yah and tell me if he hates this, all right? Quickly in the book of Devarim. Hallelujah. I want to ask you this. Devarim chapter 6, verse 27. Devarim 6, 27. He said, and they shall put my name. They shall nothan. They shall put my name upon the children of Yisrael, and I will bless them. Does he hate his name, Yisrael? Does he hate his name? But he hates our names because we have been given names under the oppressor. He hates those names. He does. He said, I will put my name. He said, I will put my name. I will not and I will store my name upon the children, upon the bane of Yisrael. And I will bless them. Numbers 6:27. So does he hate his name? He can't hate his name no more than he can hate his feast days. He hate our name. He said, that dirty thing. That David is a bastard, but he's mine. My people. If my people would humble themselves. Even though he tells us what to do. If my people will humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways and obey, then shall they hear from Hashem. And yes, I will heal their land. He will heal us. Does he hate my people? No, he doesn't hate his people. He's going to burn us, though. Ain't no doubt about that. And so if you find where Yah hates my, let me know, all right? Numbers 12:6. Hallelujah. Here it is that when Yah, he rebukes the murmuring of Aharon and Miriam. Numbers 12, verse 6. And Yah said, hear now my word. Does he hate my word, his words? Numbers 12:6. He said, hear now my words. If there be a Navi among you, I will make myself known to him in a vision, and I will speak in a dream. That's what he says. Verse 7, he says, my Abed, my servant. Was Moshe his servant? Yeah. Did he not take the commandments of Yah and throw them to the ground? But he didn't hate him, did he? He said, my servant, Moshe, is not so, who is faithful, not in your house, but in my house. He's faithful in my house. Hell, in your house, you got to be faithful to mom and daddy and wicked cousins and all of that. He said, Moshe is faithful in my house. Does Yah hate his house? But he hate our house. He hate the abomination in our house, Yisrael. But he doesn't hate my house. This is my house. He doesn't hate his house. He said, Moshe is a faithful man in my house. We are not faithful in his house, but this is his house, and he still loves his house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dibarim 5:10. We must keep the mitzvah of Yah. These are his mitzvah. From that, we see the stipulation of his statutes and his ordinance and all the writings of the Torah. From these 10 here. Dibarim 5:10, Yah says, I will show racham, mercy, to thousands of them that love me and do what? Keep my mitzvah, my commandments. Did he not command them to keep? Is that not a writing how to keep the Pesach, Matzvah, the feast days of Yah? He commanded them to come to Yerushalayim. He knew he was scattering us. And he knew that we should teach our children to remind them, for we long for the land of promise. Yes, and we have not lost perspective on the Shabbat, neither on the Moedim of Yah. These are just hard-headed men that twist the scripture. You cannot tell when it's time. They want to do it through some kind of mathematical formula. And I've studied, when I say study, I've studied, you know, things like the astrology of not horoscopes, Yisrael, but the moon and the sun. And it's so difficult. Even what they call the brightest of minds of scientists doesn't understand that. The evolution of the moon and the moon phase. They don't even understand that, Yisrael. They don't. The days and how to count and years, how to calculate. Yah said, from one new moon to the next new moon. I don't give a damn about 19 or 2012. I know from one moon to the next moon. One moon, two moon, three moon, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, one. I don't give a damn about your calculations. I will, man. You baffle the mind, you tell a man that in the Buddhist that watches for the moon to keep Yah's feast days. He got the Torah of Yah in his bosom. You got to tell him to take the refined calculation. You got to have this meditation. I do that. Yah says nowhere to do that. Give a damn what you say. You don't even understand what he's saying. And some of the most ignorant men, they try to teach things like they get everybody confused. And the simple mind believes and falls. I've seen that so much. I've seen that. No, you hear what I'm saying. Hallelujah. And you question your own heart. Hallelujah. So Yah, does he hate? He commands us in Dibarim 5:10. He shows that he will show racham, mercy upon those, the generation to 1,000. He said mercy to thousands of them that love me. That love me. Does Yah love him? He loves himself, doesn't he? He is love. He got to love himself because Yah is love. So everything comes out of him. Is it love? Sure it is, Yisrael. So his moed is love, isn't it? Our feast days are not love because they're based upon our own principle, but his feast days are. He doesn't hate his feast days. Hallelujah. Quickly, Devarim 5:29, same chapter. Hallelujah. So we're talking about Yah. He has always used an individual with those that are the intercessors. Hallelujah. We must have the ability to hear Yah Yisrael. Devarim 5:29. He says, oh, that there were such a love in his people, a heart, a mind, that they would fear me and keep my mitzvah always. That's what Yah wants. He wants us to have a heart like that. Let's keep them all dim. Let's guard them. Even though when we fail, we will still guard them and keep it in our minds. Even though we come short, Yisrael, just like the prophet Zechariah, as he began to restore things, Yisrael. Even if we don't understand the fullness of it, we will keep it. He will bring us into the light of this truth. He says, and keep my mitzvah always, that it might be well with them and with their children forever. You teach your children Pesach. Those were the great memorials of Yah. Sho'ut, Pesach, and Booth. And he commanded us to sleep. Still today, it's relevant. Well, I don't see why. Well, do we get immersed in water? Is that relevant today? Sure it is. There are those that say that that's not relevant. But it is relevant. It is, Yisrael. I don't care what the pagans have done. I don't care how many gods they have. But this is the command of Yah. It may be a great blessing with us and our children we obey. He doesn't hate himself. He is love. How could he hate himself? That's why he commands you to love your neighbors. You love yourself. You can't love nobody until you began to learn how to love you. Do you have a great concern for you? For you have a great concern of your wealth and your shoe, you can't love me. I don't care how you try, Yisrael. You cannot do that. Not at all. Hallelujah. Let's examine this quickly here. A little, I want to give you a little careful analogy here in Devarim 11:18. Look what it says here. This is a command of Yah, Deuteronomy 11:18. Yah says, now, we're still dealing with the word mine. We're generated, the possessor, the author. Yah says here in Devarim 11:18, therefore shall you lay up my daba, my word, my Devarim, my daba, in your lev and in your. Now, who is he talking to? Is he talking to your? He said, you should lay up my, and then he's talking about your. Your nefesh is not my nefesh. Your nefesh, listen to me, don't worry about that. Your nefesh is not my nefesh. So he said, you shall lay up my, he showed the possessor, the one that is in possession. He's in possession of his Devarim, is he not? And he tells us what to put that in your nefesh. You shall put it in your nefesh and bind them for a sign upon your hand. You shall keep your right hand, your yamim, the hand of strength, that they may be as a frontlet of your eyes. And you shall teach them to what? Your child is not my child. That's that man's child. That man right there, that's his child. He said, you should teach them to your child. To your child. To your child. You should teach them to your children. Speaking to them when you sit in your house. When you're in your house. Isn't that a possession? Your house is not my house. I was saying to Achmikaya, I say, Achmikaya, the other day we were talking. I said, we went out. I said, I'll be brutally honest. I said, I don't recall ever going in Zakin Yarameha's house. I said, went in Zakin Benjamin's house one time. Akshimri, the only time, I don't think have I been in your house since you've been there? I don't recall. I said, I've never been in his house. Hallelujah. Never been in his house. I've been in his house more than I've ever been in his house. Never been in his house. You understand? Yah says in your home. I haven't been in her house. I went in her house when we got the little fire up there. That was the first time and the only time. Haven't been back. And that's probably about one of the last times I've been back that way. He always said, Reach never goes back that way. That's the truth. He said, you teach him in your house. So it's your house, or my house? It's your house. That's why he said, I hate your feast days. He did not say, I hate my feast days. I say, your feast days. Isn't that possession of your house your house? Your safe house is his house. Your house is your house. Your house is your house. Come on. Is that what he's not addressing that specifically? So he addressed that he hate your feast days specifically as well. He's precise. He's the designer of all words in every language. Hallelujah. He said, your house when you shall walk by the way, when you lie down and when you rise up. He said, you should teach your children in your house. You should make known the Torah of Yah in your house. You should bring forth my dabar, my dabarim, my words of power. You should teach them to your children. He should teach them to his children. He teaches them to his children. He teaches to his child, his children. Come on, Yisrael. Where? In your house. Not in his house, but in your house you teach them. Did he have messengers to refine what you've taught? In your house, Yisrael. Don't let these dogs tell you these lies. People are falling for these lying, stupid, immature men. Have no strength. Never done anything in life. Want to do something. Want to be a leader. They're not leaders. Hallelujah. They're not leaders at all. You will know a leader because a leader, he pronounced that he's a leader. His walk identify his power, his character, his speech. I'll never forget when I worked at IBM, there was a man, his name was Tom Wallace. He was black as black too. He had a big gold tooth in front of his mouth. He's about 6 feet. He's black. But Tom was a very bright, smart individual. I was telling Akhmi Kaya the other day, and he looks at me one day, and he flashed that something. He said, you're a leader, man. Period. I didn't tell him I was a leader. He said, if a man can't recognize that, something wrong with him. If they don't realize you're a leader, man. You have the power to lead people. Come on. Come on, little crowd like this, a leader. They would call T.D. Jakes a leader. Benny Hinn, those are leaders. Hallelujah. That's all right. I would rather be a simple servant of Yah. Can I move quickly, Yisrael? I got a few more. I want to finish. Hallelujah. Is this bringing any clarity to us? All right. All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go back to Yeshaya. Isaiah 52:4. He speaks of the great refreshing of the kingdom of HaMashiach, revival. That it should bring the great instruction here that this no be prophesied. Isaiah 52, verse 4. He said, for this is what the sovereign Yah says, my people. Are we his people? Yes. Are we the people of Yah? Yes. My people went down before into Mizraim to sojourn there. And Ashur oppressed them without cause. Are we the people oppressed even in this nation without cause? Without cause because of people complexion of their skin. Without cause. He said, now therefore, what have I here, says Yah, that my people are taken away for nothing? Are we the people of Yah? Have we fallen short and come short of the expectation of Yah's honor? But we are still his people. And yet he is the one that drove us into captivity, did he not? But we are still my people. We are my people. We are the possession of Almighty Yah. He said, they that rule over you, he said, they make them howl or wail, says Yah. And then he says this, and my name continuously every day is not art, it's blaspheme, it's despised. Every day they despise the name of Yah. They will give credence to the name of Jesus on tomorrow. His people are doing that. Those that are lost in the bondage of their own religious construct, the wicked man. He said, my name is continuously not art, blaspheme. Spoken of, despised every day. You cannot blaspheme the Ruach. It's not Yah Ruach. And we think we blaspheme the Ruach. There is no forgiveness of sin. You're not going to speak against his name and reject his name and think you're going into the kingdom. Hallelujah. Some of these nutheads, that's what they are. They left from here. Well, his name is Hayah now. They're so damn stupid. They don't even know what the word means. I got hundreds of scriptures. Just on that one word. They haven't searched the book. They are stupid. They're immature and they are young boyish jackasses. I can show you in places where it says come to come went forth that says Haya. So is that and Yaakov went to it says Haya. Is that his name? They are stupid, Zachin, Yarameya. They are flat out jackasses. I know what the word chaya, I know what the verb express. I knew that before the boys began to even talk about it. When I hear something, immediately I go search diligently. I've heard this years and years. Come on, Yisraya. I can show you stuff I've written ever since I've been here. I've got thousands and thousands of writings and messages. Hallelujah. And that's the truth. He said, they blaspheme my name continuously. They na'ats, they hate it. Yah says here in verse 26, Yeshua 52 and 26, he said, therefore, my people, are we the people of Yah? He says, shall, what's the next word? Please say it, everyone. Shall what? Come on, say it loud. Just do that for me. I don't have you to do much. They shall what?
Yeah.
Just that one word. They shall what?
Yeah.
They shall yada. They shall experience. They shall understand. He said, they shall know what? My name. Does he despise my name? No, he doesn't, Yisrael. He said, my people shall know my name, and therefore they shall know in that day that I am he that does speak. Behold, it is I. We better give credence to his name, Yisrael. You cannot keep the Mo'adim of Yah without his name being exalted, praised, and lifted up. And that's why he hates their feast. If you use nothing but Yah, that's all right. But his name is a great name, Yisrael. It is not the damn name of Jesus, the Lord. He said, my people shall yada, they shall experience my name and the power of that name. And it only comes to, he's talking about this one, it comes to the power of Yahshua. We truly are in his melchut, in the kingdom of Yah. Yahshua, we live, we move, and we have our being in Yahshua. Hamashiach, hallelujah. You cannot twist this. You can do it all you want to. He hates these days that they call feast days that reject his name. Get these line scholars. I will debate any of them. Get the higher boys. That's all they are, boys. They don't even read the Torah. They don't even study the Torah. Eating like hogs and foolishness and laughter. You think they want to listen to me? I had one call me the other day and said, my husband was listening to you. And he said, I don't want you listening to that man. Anybody but him. Not that man. Not him. Anybody but that one. He'd rather they listen to dogs than to truth. They'd rather them fellowship, and they think they have fellowship. It's no fellowship with some little weak thing. They'd rather have that. The hell of fellowship with Yah and his son Yahshua. I'm not offended because of what men say about me. They spoke against Yahshua. They call him a Beelzebub and a liar and a thief. What do you think they're going to say about me? Hallelujah. Look at verse 57, verse 7 of the same chapter of 52. It tells us, we know this is the kingdom truth. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him that bring the tov news and publish shalom and bring tov tidings of tov that publish Yahshua says to Tizayon, Yah reigns. See, that's what Yahshua says. Yah reigns. He reigns. His word reigns. His dabarim reign. His feast days reign. His instructions of Torah reign. Yahshua brings us that glad tiding and that beautiful news. No one else can bring that to us, but Yahshua HaMashiach, Yahshua Yisrael. I want to touch on our ways and show you. And Yah said, I hate your feast days, doesn't he? Now I want to touch on a little of our ways, all right? Again, I want to read that word. I want to define the word Yah, all right? It is an adjective of or belonging to of yourself or yourselves or possessors or possessors due to you, inherited in you, associated or connected with you, or relating to you or yourself or yourselves as authors and authors, doers and doers, givers and givers, or agent affected by you. You're the one that affect the outcome. You understand? With this the way we go to keep it, Yah tells us how to keep his feast with simplicity. Come before him singing and dances and shouting. And then if you got food, everyone brings something together and you eat and you rejoice. Not everyone, whether you can cook or not, bring something. Yeah. I don't care what it is, you bring something. Bring something to them. Then the old Baptists did that. They, as a young lad, I remember that. And there were some places they didn't meet but every third Sunday. And yet everyone would bring something together. And cut Koran and cut Yunus and cut this one and cut that one. They would come, sit down at the table together, and they would cook enough pie, not just for their young ones, but for everyone, for slices to be spread around. And it was a feast for them because they didn't get no preaching but once a month. They didn't have cars to travel. And it would be a moed for them. It would be a solemn occasion. Would it be quiet and sober? It says in the book of Devarim, Deuteronomy 28:29. There's a prophecy, Yisra'iyah, concerning Yisra'iyah, us as a people. Because we have been so disobedient unto the Torah of Yah and the dispersing of his nation. The prophecy, it reads here, Devarim 28:29. Yah says, and you shall grope at noonday as the blind grope in darkness. And you now shall not prosper in whose ways? Your ways. Did he not save Abraham? Abraham, because he walked in his ways, in my ways he prospered. You're not going to prosper in your Mordem, in your feast days. They're going to be dead. See, he said, I hate your feast days. He did not say, I hate my feast days. He said, and you shall not prosper in your ways. And you shall only be oppressed. You're going to be defrauded. You're going to be violated. You're going to have suppression. You're going to operate in deceit and every kind of lie of extortion. That's what's going to happen. He said, and not only that, but you're going to be gazal. You're going to be spoiled. You're going to be seized. They're going to take you. You're going to be plundered in your ways. In your feast days, there's not going to be no rejoicing. You're going to feel the fatness of your nefesh, Yisra'iyah, in your feast days. Your family reunion, there's no fatness there. None whatsoever. Every day, y'all give us a family reunion. We can associate with the family of Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. He says, and you shall be spoiled as well. He said, all your days, and no man shall deliver you all of your days. He hates your Mo'adim. He hates your feast days. And we can see the beginning of that, or the pattern of the feast days. And they said, we're going to make this a feast of Yah. Oh, Christmas, it's all about Jesus. I know it's about your damn Jesus. It's not about Yahshua HaMashiach. We should remember his death, burial, and resurrection. And that's what Pesach is. That's why he said, when you come together, he says, often as you do this, do Zachar. Do remember me. Remember what I've done. Don't forget me. I'm gone, but don't forget me. I know the Torah doesn't say he cried, but if he cried in the Garden of Gethsemane because of the great power that was opposed to him, death, you think knowing what they were going to suffer, he didn't cry. You think that's the only time he cried? I can see him crying. He just don't remember. Please don't forget me. Don't forget me ever. Don't forget me. Dude, I know when the cock crow, you're going to deny me. But please, just remember. Just don't take it for granted, Thomas. Yeah, I know you need a sign. I know you're going to need that. But don't forget me. Come on, Yisra'iyah. Hallelujah. This is real. And that's what the Mo'adim is for. You understand? His great high, Pesach, begetting, Masfah, serving, searching our land that we began to sow seeds that are pure and right. Yet at the time of Sha'utz, we can bring forth abundance of riches, of Torah and offerings, serenading at the house of Yah, singing and dancing. And giving up to those, leaving our fields where others can garner from our fields. Don't take it all. That's what it's all about, Yisra'iyah, and we appreciate that. I heard one man say, the world, they got it together, they all celebrate Christmas at the same time, so what? Hitler's still a pagan. Their birthdays, then they don't celebrate them all at the same time. Not only do they not, there are different times of the year they celebrate Christmas. There are countries that celebrate the first city. There's countries that celebrate January the 15th. That's a damn lie. These beasts take something like that. They celebrate the Easter together, these religious whores. Not all nations celebrate Easter the same time this whole here. The nations don't even celebrate Christmas and stuff like that. They don't even celebrate Easter. Come on. So that doesn't mean a thing. But that's what people use as example. I don't care how far off you are, just keep the Moed of Yah. He'll bring us all into that light as he's going to bring us all to the appointed place at the appointed time. He will do that. Don't stop doing it. Hallelujah. One simple way to do it, you count the month from here. The next month will be the second month, when the first month of Yah. And you go out there, you get your, you get a calendar, a moon calendar. I have one. I pay $12 a year for it. It shows me the, and it is one of the most precise calendars I got. I purchase a moon phase clock. Paid $80-something for it. Don't talk to me about that, all right? I don't spend money foolishly because I want to keep in line and in tune with the things of Yah. And it shows you the phases of the moon. And that thing turns and keeps up with every phase. You can go out and you can identify it on that clock there. You can identify it on that calendar. Now, men that have the scholarship and the study that they know when the next full moon is, the new moon, they ain't off that far. They can take statistical data and compile that and see when it's fallen. You don't deny that, and I use that as a gauge to make sure, Yisra'iyah. Just like Shurak says, in the full moon, the beauty of the full moon, and when it is weighing, when you see the slither, search it out all you want to, it still means the same. That's what the way it is when you began to see the moon waned. He said, when you see that little wane, you know that the month is here. You know that's the full moon is there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's in your tongue all the time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeshua, you're 55:8. Are the ways of Yah like your ways? Okay, so he hates your feast days, but he doesn't hate his feast days. I don't hate my feast days. Yeshua 55:8, he says to us, he says, possessive for my thoughts. Yah has thoughts? He gave us the thoughts of his Moed, didn't he? For my thoughts are not your thoughts. That's what he says. My thoughts are not your thoughts. My feast day is not your feast day. My thoughts are not your thoughts, neither your ways, my ways. Is that what he says? My thoughts are not your thoughts, and my ways are not your ways, saith Yah. Not Yeshua, but Yah says this, for as the heavens are high above the earth, for as the heavens, the Hashemayim, are higher than the earth. Is there not? The heavens are high above the earth, isn't it? So are my ways. So are my feast days. So are my Mishpah. So is my Mishpah. So are my Mishra. So are my government. So are my ways. So are my Mishpah. So are my ways higher than your ways. My Torah ways are not your ways. My Pesach is not your way of Pesach. And my thoughts than your thought. You think you're doing it right, but you're not doing it right. You think you got it right, but it's not right. Yah doesn't hate my more them. He hates your more them. See, it's just one little word that solidify. People omit that. That one word, your. The one word, your, and the one word, my. And they don't know how to study like that, son. Oh, he hates your feast days, and yet they don't read all of that in Amos, Yah, and Yeshua. How stupid are they? And yet they derive from that, Yah hates his feast days. They're liars. Tell Obadiah to listen to this. Someone write him and tell him. He's not going to listen to this. Because they're cowardly men. If Yah hates his feast days, he hates his mitzvah. He hates his Torah. He hates my people. He hates my thoughts. His thoughts now, if he hates that. Because did he not say this is my Pesach? Did he not take possession of that? Is it not a possessive? So if he hates that, he hates everything else. He hates your, mine. He doesn't hate his. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We are just like this. We got this superficial confidence that we say we love Yahshua and we really don't. We as a nation of Israel, we really need to see the hand. We need to see the beauty of Yahshua. This is the prophecy of Jeremiah, Jeremiah 2 and 33. Quickly, I have a few verses I want to read because I am tired. I didn't sleep well last night. I did not. Hallelujah. I really didn't. I was having a little problem here, but I'm all right. All right. Right here, yeah. Jeremiah 2:33. Yah says to this whorish nature of Yehuda and Israel, it's the same. He says, why do you embellish your ways, your derech? Why do you think your ways are so beautiful, the way you do? Why do you embellish your ways to seek love? You're embellishing your ways and make them beautiful because you're trying to seek love. When we have the feast, we'll just be like a chameleon. We'll alter, we'll flip-flop to please you. No, his ways are not our ways. So why do we embellish our ways to seek love? Therefore, you have also taught the wicked ones. Does he say that? These men teach wicked ones whose ways? The ways of Yah, their ways, your ways. You have taught the wicked ones your ways. You think your ways are right. Well, you don't have to keep the feast days. You don't have to keep the Shabbat. Because you're a dirty bastard, you don't keep it because your job is more important. So you tell everybody else that. And so you embellish your ways. I know what I'm saying. I know what I'm saying. You're a liar. So y'all say, why you embellish your ways? It's so you can have someone around you say, oh, I love you, brother. You don't give a damn about him. Why you embellish your ways, y'all says. Therefore, you have also taught, he didn't say you have taught the righteous one. You have taught the wicked ones your ways. You've taught men that are flat out wicked and dirty to do the same dirty things you do. You taught them to say that Yah hates his feast days. And you will not keep them. You don't want to keep them because you're responsible to your job. You got responsibility to everyone but Yah. Isn't it amazing how we're responsible to everyone but Yah? Hallelujah. This is what we have to do as a nation. Jeremiah 4:14. Look what we have to do. Do we not gather in the heart of Yerushalayim? Because that's the city where the Shalom of Yah is taught. That's what Yerushalayim means. Hallelujah. Yah says here in Jeremiah 4:14, Yerushalayim, wash your lev. He did not tell you to wash my lev, did he? He said, wash your lev. He said, I hate your feast days. He hates your heart. He said, wash your lev from what? From wickedness. From your wickedness. That you may be delivered. How long shall your vain thoughts lodge in you? Yah talked about their vain oblations and their vain sacrifices, their vain burnt offerings. Did I not read that? So how long shall the shah of these vain thoughts dwell in you? Vain, emptied, foolishness. No thoughts. You don't have to keep the Mordim of Yah, then you don't have to keep the Shemot. Because we're not in Yerushalayim. They're stupid, stupid men. You're stupid. Or there'll be some of those fools, they will go online and listen to me. They go in there and kind of, they'll listen. They don't hear, but they'll listen to see. Hallelujah. I don't like to mention their names, any of these fools. I really don't. I did that for a purpose because I hope the person that wrote and commented, asking this beast that put that on that, this faggot, contact me quickly. I want to know. Instead of calling me and say, Riak, I will explain things to him. I owe him nothing to explain, but I would have done that. Who hasn't dealt with people that has been disgruntled? They leave jobs disgruntled. Husband leaves wives and ridicule them. Wives leave husband. And the dirty cow will say, I would never do it. And the next thing you know, he's in a court of law. Come on, Yisrael. Oh, everything is well. I still love him and we are friends. We are not friends, Heifer. You take him to the wicket. Not trusting his ability to do right? Tell me where people have not been disgruntled and they have not lied. Tell me anyone say that I've been a man that loved money. I would not be here if I love money. Or you will not be here. I will have me a 3,000-4,000 square foot crib. And bring it in everything I can for tithes and offerings. Give me a little something. Hard as I work, are you talking about loving money? We got a roll tomorrow. My Akka, your Wasadak say, Ray, how can we do this, this, and that? I say, man, we got that kind of manpower, but I tell you what, we're going to try it. I said, if we get three rows, like, oh, we can get that up. He speaks so and so humble and so assured. I'm like, all right. We got one pulling, we got one doing this one. We go down the line, nailing this, we go down. I said, I'm thinking about putting four on. He said, no, we need to put five because you're going to have a. I said, I tell you what, I put the three on the top, but I'm not bending down to put the two at the bottom. I nail everything on that post until we get to the bottom. I'm telling you the truth. He said, we can do it, Rayak. I said, I tell you what, Yahweh, I said, doctor, we can get all the way down to the end and back on that back. I said, man, I said, I can get Yosef over there on the first or second day, and we can pull one roll if nothing else. I said, I have the first 90% of the time with him, but we'll get it down. Won't we, Yosef? That's right. I said, we'll get it down. He said, we can get it down. He spoke so valiantly. I want to close here with these few verses, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 4. Let us not walk in our vain ways. Look at verse 18 quickly. The prophet says, this is the, he says, your ways is in our ways. Jeremiah 4:18, your ways and your doings have asah or procured the very indignation of Yah, these things to you. He said, this is your wickedness because it is bitter, because it reaches to your heart. That's why he hate your feast days. He doesn't hate his feast days, Yisrael. There's nowhere in the book where he tells us. He commands us to remember them throughout the generations forever. Olam vi'at. Olam, it is forever, eternity without ceasing. He hates our feast days. He hates the way they come together, full of iniquity, no repentance, no heart to sincerely serve Yah. The women coming in that dressing, and the men nothing but dogs, lustful, laying up in shack in their drunkenness. Come on, Yisrael. He said, I hate that. You can't bring an offering of praise unto me out of that kind of cauldron of wickedness. They're going to have all their little whore daughters in the whole house tomorrow, dressed like dirty slut holes. Mama shacking, laying out all night tonight, but they're going to the whole house tomorrow. Their Baptist whole house, their Methodist, and all of that, Yisrael. They will be there. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And that's what he says, it's your wickedness and your doings have procured this unto you. I can show you hundreds and hundreds of scriptures on your and mine. And show me anywhere where Yah said, I hate mine. He said, I hate your. We must learn how to define words. We just can't read this like a novel. We got to read, study. We got to meditate on each word, Yisrael. That's why things don't get past me. People say things. I say, no, come on, Ark. I've said the Ark even here. Let's hold up. No, let's go back. No. You missed the whole point because you didn't read these 10 verses up there. Let's start there and explain each verse. When you get to here, you understand that. Yeshaya, quickly. I'm sorry, Yeskel. Ezekiel. And I want to go back to Yeshaya. But Ezekiel, Yeskel 16:30. This is the state of Yisrael, his people. How weak is your lev? Is your lev weak? Sure it is, Yisrael. That's why Dawid said, let the weak say I am strong, or the poor say I. Our lev is weak. We fall prey to some of the weakest things. Yah says, how weak is your lev? He hate your feast days. He hate the weakness of our hearts. He said, your lev, Yisrael, is weak, says the sovereign. Yah says it's weak, so it's weak. Seeing you do all these things, he says, the work of an imperious, whorish woman. You do these things to procure unto yourself someone to like you. I'm not going to alter the things of Yah for someone to come fellowship with us. Yeah. Ozake Mahalias, he closed it up, you know. I was not discouraged because it's just a few of us. He said, it makes no difference how many it is of us. We come together in the name of Almighty Yah. Men that have stood here and been with us, say they loved us. Come on, Yisrael. He said, it makes no difference. Who cares? It is right, my young Ark. I'm not concerned about that. I'm never concerned about that. When it was three of us that were my Ishar, when my Ema here came, and a cousin, should I preach just like this? And we go back and listen to it. I was happy. At least it was one more, two or three gathered. I was happy as a dog on a pile of rotten bones. Sure I was. So I've never been discouraged. Yeah, if he's ever put something in my left that day, don't be discouraged, son. When you walk this way, you're not going to find many. I didn't understand that, but the more I walk in his Torah, I see that there are very few that love Yah. Few that be that make it in. And that's a fact. Two more verses that I'm closing here. Isaiah, Yeshaya 47:10. For you, is he talking about you, me? He said, for you, have trusted in whose wickedness? Your wickedness. That's why he hate our wicked feast days. Your feast days. He hates your damn birthdays. You get drunk. You stagger. You invite everybody. You spend money. You won't give him a damn dime. People go out and spend hundreds of dollars for a child birthday party, and we're not giving an offering to Yah. Yah says, for you have trusted in your wickedness. You have said, none see me. He says, look at what he says. Your wisdom and your knowledge, it has perverted you. That's what has perverted us. Your wisdom, not the wisdom of Yah. He commands us to keep my chukmah. My mishpatim, my chukhem. He says, your wisdom and your knowledge have perverted you, and you have said in your heart, I am, and there is none beside me. You have the same spirit as Hashatan. Same one. Just like it was in the Tasnut, they began their own feast days and could not take knowledge of what Yah had done in his Pesach. This is for us as I close out of the breath of Shaul. Kephar, he says to us, I'm not going to tell you where this is at. He says, repent therefore of your wickedness, of your wickedness. Did I not just read that Yah says you trust in your wickedness? Shaul said, repent of your wickedness and pray to Yah if perhaps the thoughts of your heart may be forgiven. That's what Kephar said to Shimeon. He said, you pray and repent of your wickedness. Yah hates our wickedness. And our wickedness is transcribed in your feast days. And your feast days is an action of your wickedness. So he hates them. But my feast days, he loves. He loves his name being exalted. He loves for us to sing and to dance and to shout. He loves his feast days. He loves his feast days. You packing up to leave my ark? Okay then. All right then. Okay, I saw you putting things up. So, okay. He's not packing up to leave. Beautiful. Hallelujah. You that have joined us, we greet you all. Your sure is mighty name. We've had some difficulties, but all is well. We got to trust Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anything I teach you, I can get hundreds of scripture. I'm not trying to prove me. I'm proving him. He hates your feast days, but he loves his more them. He delights in Pesach. That's why we're going to sing and dance and rejoice, and we're going to eat. We're going to always do it. It's going to be a beautiful place. We're going to dress it up. We're going to fix it up. We're going to dress. I don't care. You go to Walmart. Yeah, go to Walmart. Get you some material. Make your frock. Make your dress. Make your shirt. Do it. We're going to do that. Hallelujah. And that's a fact. Every Moed, we gather to lift up his name. His name. And these three major ones, Matzvah, Mishaut, and Sukkot, that's what we do. Let us stand to our feet. Yabarak you all. You that have joined us, do assist and help. May Yah barak you and strengthen you. Let us turn toward Yerushalayim. In all things we do, barak you, Yah. Your surest name, we told you for your great riches and blessings. We just ask you to bless Yisraya, to barak, to bow your ears to us, Yah. What a great blessing. We know you hate our feast days, but we know you love your Moed. We shall honor them even in our ignorance, Yah. We shall strive to understand the fullness and the complete truth of that. Help us, Yah. Help your servants, the simple ones, your messengers. Strengthen their bosom. Scatter. Strengthen all Yisrael, wherever they are scattered. We told you for Matzvah. As we enjoy this, we search our love for wickedness from everything that is offensive to you. Bless us all, those that join us, strengthen Barak in Yahshua's mighty name. That's our request of thee this day. We have food, bread, and much to eat. We have homes and clothes. We need nothing else. We ask all things in the blessed assurance of the only name, Yahshua HaMashiach. And with our voices, we Barak you. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Yabarak Yisrael.